Okay, so this example is going to cover just further examples with angles in different situations that we might come across, especially the technical field. So here we have a carpenter square is placed over a board as shown. And notice that when we do that, these two angles here are created. We have angle one and we have angle two. So if angle one measures 62 degrees, so this side over here on the left is 62 degrees. So what then would be the measure of angle two? So the main thing that we need to pay attention to, or that we need to notice when it comes to this particular example here, is first off taking a look at the board that we have. Right, so the board is laying flat across over here, and we're putting a carpenter square on it as shown in this picture here. But when we have a board, right, a board is pretty flat, right? So a board is a straight line across. So what we need to keep in mind here is what a straight line or what a straight angle would equal. Technically, if I'm looking from angle one over here all the way to angle two, all the way across this board, so this is called a straight angle, right? And what we need to know about that is that a straight angle equals 180 degrees, right? It's a semicircle. So that if we know that this angle one here, if angle one is 62 degrees, what is this angle off over here? Well, any straight line. So if you find a straight line in any of the examples that you're dealing with, a straight line, well, that's 180. So I have this straight line here. And if up until this point here is 62, what's the remainder? Right, so if that's 180, I know 62, I need to figure out what the rest of this piece is. Really, all we have to do is take that 180 degrees and we need to subtract the 62 from it. And that's going to give us the missing angle. So if we calculate 180 minus 62, we're left with 118 degrees. So that means that angle two over there, this one here, I know this is starting to get a little messy, right? So that would be 118 degrees. So that's what we're looking for here.